Welcome back. In the last lecture, we downloaded and installed JDK with public JRE. Let us now write our first Java program. Open Notepad++ and start writing your first Java program. In Java, everything needs to be coded inside a class. So we'll first define our class. Public class, my first class. Open the bracket and note that Notepad++ has already provided the closing brackets. Press enter 2-3 times. Now provide the main method, public static void main string arguments. Open the brackets. Again, Notepad has provided closing bracket. We'll write one statement, system.out.println. First, Java class using Notepad++. Now don't worry if you don't understand anything right now. I'll explain the code line by line, and in a day or two you will start writing Java codes without any help. In this lecture, I just want to show you the steps you need to follow to write, compile and execute your Java programs. Let us save this file. Control S. I am going to save it inside work. I'll create one folder named code. The save as type I'll change to Java. Now the name of the file should match with the name of the public class that you had provided. So in this case should be my first class. Please note that Java is case sensitive, so my first class is different from this my first class. So make sure you use the same case as with the class name. Save the file. Now open the command prompt. Go to this directory, C drive work code, dir, my first class.java file is here. Now to compile this, type java c my first class.java. Done. No errors. Now if there are no errors, then Java C compiler will compile your Java files and then create a class file. So let's check the contents of the directory. You will see my first class.class file. Now let's go to this directory and try to open the class file. You can see it cannot be opened in a text editor. It is a binary file, and this class file can be run or executed in Java Virtual Machine. To execute the class file, you need to type Java and the class file name without the dot class extension. So my first class. Press enter, and whatever you had written in the system.out.println statement, it will be printed to the console. Now suppose there were some errors in the file. Currently I know that every statement in Java should end with a semicolon, and if semicolons are not there, it's a compile time error. So let us now remove this semicolon. Save this file. I'll go to the directory and I'll just delete this dot class file. I'll go to the command prompt and try to compile the same file again. Java C my first class.java. Now it is giving me a compilation error. At line number 3, there is some error. Semicolon is expected. It has provided me the line number as well on which the semicolon is missing. So let us first correct this error. Save the file and we can compile the code again. But before that, let us go back to the same location and see whether the class file was generated or not. So when the compilation failed, there was no class file that was generated. Let us compile the code again. Java C my first class.java, and this time the compilation is successful. The class file was generated successfully. Let us execute this file. Java my first class, and you can see the output as well. In the next lecture, we'll write the same Java program in Eclipse IDE. See you there.